Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today, let's look at the line-by-line explanation of the chapter Albert Einstein at School from Class 11 English. If you're watching my video for first time, consider subscribing. You can listen to the explanations of lessons from Classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. Albert Einstein at School is written by Patrick Pringle. Lawrence Patrick Pringle is an American writer. He has won a lot of awards and he's also the member of the Authors Guild. Albert Einstein is regarded as the greatest physicist since Newton. In the following extract from The Young Einstein, the well-known biographer Patrick Pringle describes the circumstances which led to Albert Einstein's expulsion from a German school. So Albert Einstein is studying in a German school. So the first scene in the story is his classroom and he is having a conversation with his history teacher. In what year, Einstein asked the history teacher, did the Prussians defeat the French at the Waterloo? So his history teacher is asking him a question. And what is the question he's asking? He's asking, in which year did the Prussians defeat the French at the Battle of Waterloo? I don't know, sir. And he replies that he does not know the answer. Why don't you know? You have been told it often enough. So his sir is very angry with him and asking him, why is that you don't know the answer? And many times I have told you the correct answer. I must have forgotten. So he replies that he must have forgotten the year. Did you ever try to learn? So the teacher is very angry with him and is asking him, did you ever try to learn the answer which you did not know? Asked Mr. Brown. So Mr. Brown is the history teacher. No, sir, Albert replied with his usual unthinking honesty. So he was very plain and he did not think at all and he quickly answered that I did not know or I did not even try to learn. He did not want to tell lies to his teacher. Why not? I can't see any point in learning dates. So his teacher asks him, why is it you did not try to learn when you don't know? So he says that I can't see any point in learning dates. So what did he mean by that? He feels that there is no meaning or there is no use of learning dates. One can always look them up in a book because he feels that you can always look up the dates in any book. So you don't have to learn anything by heart. So if you want to know the dates, it is easy. You can just take a book and learn. So that was Albert Einstein's idea about learning the dates. He says that it's not necessary to by heart the dates. Mr. Brown was speechless for a few moments. So who is Mr. Brown? He is the history teacher. He became speechless for a few moments. That means he never expected such an answer because the student was telling him that it's not necessary to learn dates because you can always open any book and find out the dates. You amaze me, Einstein. So the teacher told him that you amaze me. I feel very surprised by looking at children like you. Don't you realize that one can always look most things up in books? So his teacher tells him that, don't you know that anything and everything can be looked up in books? That means there is no need to learn anything by heart at all. That applies to all the facts you learn at school. So he is trying to tell him that, okay, you don't have to learn anything because whatever you learn, especially the facts that you learn at school, can be looked up at into any of the books. Yes, sir. So he immediately agrees with the teacher. Then I suppose you don't see any point in learning facts. So immediately the teacher asks him that, I feel that you believe that there is no point in learning any kinds of facts because facts can always be looked up from any of the textbooks. Frankly, sir, I don't, said Albert. So Albert immediately said that yes, he does not believe in learning facts because they can be looked up in the books. Then you don't believe in education at all. So immediately the teacher wanted to know whether Albert Einstein believed in education because he says that there is no use of learning. You can always look into the books. Oh yes, sir, I do. I don't think learning facts is education. So immediately Albert Einstein came out with his idea about education. He says that it is not important to learn facts, because he says, according to him, facts can always be found in the books. So he feels that learning facts is not education. So Albert flushed. So what is the meaning of flush? Flush means to feel blushed, because he felt a little bit embarrassed, because he felt the situation was totally awkward and he had to explain what his theory of education was. I think it's not facts that matter, but ideas. So according to Einstein, he feels that it is not important to learn facts, because facts can be looked up into any book or textbook, but ideas. So he says that it is more important to learn the ideas, the which, what and how of things. I don't see the point in learning the dates of battles or even which of the armies killed more men. So he's saying it's not important to learn the dates or which army was victorious or etc. He wanted to know some other details which were more interesting. So this is what he said is the Einstein theory of education. Not learning facts, but learning about the ideas is more important. And he said, I'd be more interested in learning why those soldiers were trying to kill each other. So he said that he would not be interested in knowing the dates. He would be interested in knowing why certain things happened. That's enough. Mr. Brown's eyes were cold and cruel. So listening to Einstein's answer, the teacher, the history teacher, Mr. Brown, became very angry and he asked him to stop. And that anger was visible in his eyes also. We don't want a lecture from you, Einstein. So the teacher was not happy with the reply that Einstein said, and he told him that we don't want a big lecture from you, especially explaining your theory of education. You will stay in for an extra period today, although I don't imagine it will do you much good. So he got very angry with Einstein and told him that you will have to stay for an extra period today. And he also said that that will not be of any use to him, because according to him, he felt whatever ideas Mr. Einstein was telling was not correct according to him. So he says that it may not do you any good by staying an extra period. It won't do the school any good either. So he said that you staying an extra period will not be helpful to the school also. You are a disgrace. So he got very angry and he told Albert Einstein that he was a disgrace. Disgrace means something that brings shame. I don't know why you continue to come. So he was very angry and he said, I don't like such children like you. And he was just thinking, why is that you students like you continue to come? Because he was not interested in learning and he had his own theory about learning. And whatever he said was not correct according to the teacher. It's not my wish, sir, Albert pointed out. So when the teacher told him that it's you are a disgrace and it's no use of children like you coming to school, so he said, it's not my wish, sir. That means he says that even I don't like to come to the school. Then you are an ungrateful boy and ought to be ashamed of yourself. Then he says that you are an ungrateful boy. What is ungrateful? You're not thankful to anybody, because especially your parents who has tried to put you in school so that you can learn something, and ought to be ashamed of yourself. Why he should be ashamed of himself? Because he is not interested in learning according to the teacher. I suggest you ask your father to take you away. So the teacher is telling the boy to tell his father to take him away from school. Albert felt miserable when he left school that afternoon. What is miserable? Feeling very sad. So he felt sad after leaving school that day in the afternoon, and that it had been a bad day. So he felt that that day was a bad day. Most days were bad now anyway. So he feels that most of his days are bad and not any good anymore. But because he had to go back to the hateful place the next morning. So why he feels that every day is equally bad? Because every next day he had to go to that hateful place. What is this hateful place? The school. So he did not like to go to that school. So he feels sad every day. So though he goes home the next day, he feels that he has to get up and go back to the same school. So he feels that every day is a bad day because he hated that school. He only wished his father would take him away, but there was no point in even asking. So he wished that his father would really take him away. But he knew that there is no use of asking because his father would never agree to take him away. His father would want him to complete this course so that he would get the certificate. He knew what the answer would be. He would have to stay until he had taken his diploma. So he knew that even if he asked his father to take him away, his father would only tell him to complete the course and get his diploma. Going back to his lodgings did not cheer him up. Lodgings means the place where he stay. Cheer him up means make him feel happy. So he did not even like to go back to the place where he stayed. His father had so little money to spare that Albert had been found a room in one of the poorest quarters of Munich. So his father was not so rich, so he had to find some place in Munich, especially it was one of the poorest quarters. That means it was kind of a slum area and the lodgings was not good at all. There was very little facilities. It was surrounded by dirt and squalor. The atmosphere was that of a slum. He did not mind the bad food and lack of comfort or even the dirt and squalor. But he hated the atmosphere of slum violence. That means he did not mind whether the food was bad or even the lack of comfort or even if the place is surrounded by dirt and squalor. Squalor means extremely dirty due to negligence. But he hated the atmosphere of slum violence. So it was a slum area where he was living, and what he hated most was the slum violence. That means how people fought with each other all the time there. So he could not tolerate that. His landlady beat her children regularly, and every Saturday her husband came drunk and beat her. So the place he was staying, the landlady was always beating her children. The landlady in whose house he was staying, so that lady was always beating her children. And every Saturday her husband came drunk and beat her. So what happened on every weekend? The Saturday the husband would come, he would also be drunk and he would beat up the lady. So there was always beating and violence around him. Now who is this landlady? The landlady is the owner of the place where he lived. But at least you have a room of your own, which is more than I can say. So he had a friend called Yuri, and Yuri was always trying to console him. What did he say? At least you have a room which is more than what I can see. I don't even have a proper room to stay. That is what his friend Yuri used to tell him. So who is Yuri? Yuri is only friend, and he was a medical student who was senior to him. So he used to always find solace in this friend, and this friend used to always try to console him. So he told him that at least you have a place to stay. I don't even have that much, said Yuri when he called round in the evening. At least you live among civilized human beings, even if they're all poor students. But then Einstein told him that, okay, even if you don't have your own place, you at least live among civilized human beings. What do you mean by civilized human beings? People who know how to live, who know to live decently. That is, here means that without any fighting or violence or whatever, even if they're all poor students. So even if you stay among people, they may be poor, but they're all civilized. But my condition is not like that. I always have to stay along with the slum violence. So immediately Yuri replied. What did he reply? They are not civilized. That means the people I am staying with, the poor students I am staying with, they are also not so civilized. I hope you liked today's video. We'll look at the next part of the lesson in the next video. For more informative videos, do subscribe to My CBSE English Teacher. Like, share, and give your valuable comments below. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching.